Hello everyone, Chris here from Spoon Graphics. Today's video isn't necessarily a tutorial as such, but it's more of a guide to a bunch of techniques for making black and white images, which is especially handy for all you photography lovers out there. Black and white photography has been popular since people very first began capturing moments with cameras. Originally, it was because you didn't have any other choice, but even when colour film was widely available, monochrome images still allowed photographers to capture scenes with much deeper moods and atmospheres. Even with the high-tech cameras of today, you still can't beat the nice tones of a black and white photo. But rather than shoot onto monochrome film, we now use digital software to alter the appearance of the image. There's a range of tools you can use that all provide different results. They all effectively make an image black and white, but some do it much better than others. So in today's video, I'll give you the best and worst ways to make your photos black and white. So let's start with the worst ways first. These are all techniques you'll definitely want to avoid in favour of the better options we'll discuss later. Desaturate under the Image Adjustments and Desaturate option, or the Hue and Saturation slider in Photoshop, is often the first tool people reach for to make an image black and white. Sure, it does the job, but the difference is it just removes the colour without taking into consideration the tones of the image. The result is a washed out picture where a red and a blue might just look the same shade of grey. Another common mistake Photoshop users make is to convert their image into grayscale. This destructively edits your photo and discards all the colour information. It also results in a boring, washed out appearance. Photoshop even gives you a warning saying, "Are you sure you really want to do this?" So with these bad practices out of the way, let's take a look at some of the best techniques you can use to create dark, powerful black and white photos. The channel mixer is the classic black and white conversion tool in Photoshop. It allows you to target each colour spectrum individually to carefully adjust and balance the tonal range to find the best contrast in your shot. Apply the channel mixer as an adjustment layer to avoid permanently editing your image, then check the monochrome option. You can then move the red, green and blue sliders for each channel to boost the contrast just the way you want it by darkening or lightening specific areas like the sky. Keep an eye on the total levels though. If you exceed 100%, it means you're blowing out some of the whites. The black and white adjustment layer has been around since Photoshop CS3, which pretty much replaces the channel mixer. It has the same controls as the channel mixer, but with even more colour sliders and additional options like the ability to add a tint for a classic sepia effect or cold horror movie vibe. There's a range of presets you can choose from to mimic old school lens filters, or you can adjust the tones of the image directly by checking the click and drag option. So far I've only touched on Photoshop tools, but an equivalent to the black and white tool in Photoshop is Lightroom's B&W mix options. It features even more colour sliders to allow you to target the tones to an even finer extent. The final technique for converting an image to black and white is the use of a gradient map. This technique doesn't give you the professional control of the channels like the other tools, but it results in unique effects that can add to the impact of your photos. After adding a gradient map adjustment layer, edit the colour selections of the gradient bar. You can choose a simple two-colour gradient such as a pure black and pure white, or unusual selections like a dark blue and a creamy yellow for more of a toned look. The gradient map will replace all the tones in the image with an equivalent colour selection from the gradient spectrum. Adding multiple steps in the gradient allows you to create really cool effects that add different hues to certain parts of the tonal range to make your pics the hottest on Instagram. So I hope you find these tips for converting your images to black and white useful. If you did, a thumbs up to help spread the word would be really appreciated, or a share with your friends on Twitter or Facebook if you think my videos are worth watching. If you're new and you want to stick around yourself, be sure to hit that subscribe button on YouTube, or you can check out my website at spoon.graphics for plenty of written tutorials and free design resources. So as always, thank you very much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.